This video is brought to you by CatBeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
Here are 10 players under the age of 24 that I believe can take the next step in the 2019-2020 NBA season. Before I get started, I want to thank today's sponsor, CatBeast.com. If you want to make your own snapbacks and custom hats, be sure to click the link down below in the description box below. If you enjoy these types of videos, I'd greatly appreciate it if you could drop a like and subscribe if you're new for weekly NBA content. And in the next video and the next episode of this series, we're going to come out with players over the age of 24 that can take the next step. And that, I think, will be a little bit more interesting because those are the players that are kind of reaching the prime of their careers. You kind of reach your prime at 26, 27 years old. So that will be a little bit more interesting. And if you want to watch that video, be sure to let me know down below in the comment section. None of these players are in order. These are just 10 players that I believe should step up next season. These are all players under the age of 24. Let's get it started with number 10. At number 10, Aaron Gordon. Aaron Gordon actually had a much better season at the age of 22 compared to last season at age 23. Previously, he averaged 17.5 points, 8 rebounds, shooting 69% from the free throw line, 33% from 3, and 43% from the field goal. Playing okay defense, but nothing special. He averaged a steal per game and almost a block per game. But last season, he actually decreased and he went from 17.5 to 16 points, 8 rebounds to 7.5 rebounds, less than one steal, but as a whole, he didn't really do much compared to the year before, playing only one more minute per game. I do believe that Aaron Gordon can be a 20-point scorer in this league, and 20 points and 8 to 9 rebounds per game playing for the Orlando Magic is actually something that I think is definitely possible. And I believe that Aaron Gordon entering his fifth season in the league definitely has a chance to reach at least some of his potential. If he can average 20 and 8 at the power forward position alongside Vucevic, and if some of the other guys on the Magic can step up a little bit, I believe the Magic can actually take that next step in the Eastern Conference. Number 9, Mitchell Robinson. Mitchell Robinson is a very interesting player, as he was selected in the second round, pick number 36 of last year's NBA draft. Obviously, last season he was a rookie, and I tend to not include rookies on this list, but I think he's definitely going to be in the running to win Most Improved Player next season. He only started 19 games last year and only played 20 minutes per game. The Knicks had DeAndre Jordan last season, and obviously now he's not on the team. And obviously Robinson this season is the starting center, well, most likely for the New York Knicks. They added a lot of power forwards like Taj Gibson, Julius Randle, Bobby Portis, Marcus Morris. So there are players that will fill in the void of the big man position if Mitchell Robinson goes down with an injury. But all those guys are either small forwards or power forwards. So Robinson's spot looks pretty set. And I just believe he can make a huge leap in the way he plays. Obviously, last season, only 20 minutes per game. He averaged 7 points, 2.5 blocks, which is just insane. Only 6.5 rebounds. If he puts on a little bit of size this season, he can possibly average around 10 to 12 points per game. 3 blocks, which is just insane. A steal per game. Maybe 8 to 10 rebounds per game as well. And I believe that that is very impressive for a guy that is only going to be 21 next season. That's my prediction for Mitchell Robinson. I think he's going to have a huge leap, but I also don't think it's much of a surprise, as we all know that Mitchell Robinson will probably develop into a decent player, simply of how we saw him last season. At number 8, Karl-Anthony Towns. Karl-Anthony Towns is already a cemented player in this league. He is already an all-star, and he's already a player that you would build a team around. But the way I view this list is that I believe that these players will take the next step. That is all the video is. So obviously, I think Aaron Gordon has the potential, Mitchell Robinson has the potential. Karl-Anthony Towns' potential is much higher than anybody else on this list. I believe that he can take the next step, which means becoming an MVP in this league. Now, the only issue with Karl-Anthony Towns is that he plays for the Minnesota Timberwolves, and they're probably not going to be a very good team. If somehow Karl-Anthony Towns can improve, become one of the, if not the best big man in the league, he can elevate his team somehow to the playoffs. It's very tough because he's in the Western Conference. If he was in the Eastern Conference, I believe he would legitimately have a chance to be an MVP candidate. But just being in the West and not being able to make the playoffs makes it so tough for him to be an MVP candidate. But in saying that, Karl-Anthony Towns, in just his second season, averaged 25 and 12, shooting 54% from the field. Last year, at age 23, he actually had a worse season, only averaging 24 points, 12.5 rebounds, shooting 51% from the field, 1.6 blocks per game, and a bout of steal as well. Obviously, last season he had to share the shots with Jimmy Butler and Andrew Wiggins. This season, there is no doubt that he is the man on this team. And if he could average 25 points at 21 years old, I believe at 24 years old, he can increase that to around 28 to 30 points per game. Karl Anthony Towns legitimately has a chance to be a 30-point scorer next season. If he can average around 30 points and around 13 rebounds per game, he is a legit chance to win the MVP next season. Hopefully the Minnesota Timberwolves can make a little bit of a push. Hopefully Andrew Wiggins can be that other player that takes a little bit of a surprising jump. And if Wiggins can take a jump, Towns improves just a little bit more, the Minnesota Timberwolves might be a very surprising team next season. So look out for that. But I believe that Towns could definitely be an MVP candidate next season. Number 7, Jonathan Isaac. Jonathan Isaac is a similar player to Aaron Gordon, obviously since they play on the same team. I was extremely high on Jonathan Isaac when he first got drafted, and he was my favorite player coming out of that draft class at the time. But obviously he hasn't done too much in the NBA. Last season he only averaged around 9.6 points, 5.5 rebounds in 26 minutes per game. He has the chance to improve quite a bit. I read that he put on a lot of weight as he increased his weight from the lanky 209 pounds to 234 pounds, and obviously that 25 pounds of weight will be something that Isaac can use to his advantage. He's also 6'10", but he really looks taller when you watch him play. Isaac is also a decent shooter. He shot 42% from the field goal last season and 32% from the three. But the year before, he shot almost 35%. So I believe that if Isaac can just continue to improve on his shot, he can go from a 9.6 point scorer to maybe a 13 point scorer, and then the next year, maybe 16 to 18 points per game, as he is only 22 years of age next season. And it takes some players who are a little bit more lanky but show potential. And to me, this is a huge extreme, but Giannis took his time to develop. Give Isaac just a little bit more time to develop before you start really putting him in a category of how good he'll be in this league. At number 6, Lonzo Ball. Despite the hype that he has, Lonzo Ball has kind of been a little bit of a disappointment in the league. I mean, you don't really think about it, but his stats really show that he hasn't been as good as people make him out to be. Or on the reverse, he also hasn't really been given the opportunity, and he's also been just very injury prone to start his career. So I believe a fresh start in New Orleans with players like Zion Williamson and the continuous growth of Brandon Ingram, and obviously a guy like Drew Holiday to mentor Lonzo and help him out on the wing. He only played 47 games, and that's been something that's kind of tarnished Lonzo Ball at the start of his career. Just the fact that he's never played over 55 games and he's really just been injury prone. He only averaged 9.9 points last season, 5.3 rebounds, 5.4 assists, 1.5 steals per game, shooting 40% from the field and 32% from three. In spurts, we've seen Lonzo Ball just play very well, being a guy that you can say, wow, he can legitimately be a very good player in this league. But the fact that he was a top three pick and he really hasn't shown that is something that's been pretty disappointing. But next season, playing alongside the guys that I mentioned, I believe he can go from averaging around 10 points to maybe 12 points, but the rise in assists, I believe he can definitely contribute to. Think about this. Lonzo Ball, you think of him as an assist-first player. Playing alongside LeBron James really didn't help him out, and I think that really tarnished Lonzo Ball last season. A point guard that he only averaged 5.4 assists in 30 minutes per game. Like, that is pretty bad in my opinion. Being a pass-first point guard to only average 5 assists is pretty bad. So a stat line that I think Lonzo Ball could average next season: 12 points per game, 8.5 assists, 5 rebounds, 2 steals, and improving his 3-point percentage to maybe a 35%. At number 5, I have Lonzo Ball's teammate, Brandon Ingram. Just like Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram has had some pretty rough luck over the last few seasons where he hasn't really been able to stay healthy. In 2017-2018, he only played 59 games, and last season he only managed to play 52. But when he did play, he actually played very well. And when LeBron wasn't on the court, Ingram showed what he could be, and he gave us some glimpses into why he was a top 3 pick in the league. Brandon Ingram averaged 18 points, 5 rebounds, shooting 49% from the field and 33% from the 3-point range. I believe that Brandon Ingram in a new system will be able to improve even more, and hopefully he can stay healthy. Next season, he could average around 22 points, 6 rebounds, shooting basically what he's shooting at the moment at 33% and 49% from the field, and he is only 21 years old. Next season, he'll be 22, and a 22-year-old averaging around 22 points per game is actually scary to think about, so watch out for Brandon Ingram next season. At number 4, I have John Collins. John Collins really benefited from Trae Young playing together, in my opinion. I think Trae Young getting drafted and John Collins being able to elevate his game, he went from a 10-point scorer to a 19-point scorer in just one season. A 9-point difference in only 6 more minutes. That is insane. He went from 7 rebounds to almost 10 rebounds. He averaged less blocks, but his defensive prowess, due to his athleticism, was something that really took my eye last season. I believe that John Collins and his continuous play alongside Trae Young, if they can grow together, this could be a 1-2 punch that can definitely take the league by storm in the next few seasons. They're in the Eastern Conference, which gives them a little bit more of an advantage, considering that obviously it's easier to make the playoffs in the Eastern Conference. And obviously they have a good young core of Cam Reddish, DeAndre Hunter, Trae Young, John Collins. This can be a very scary team. If John Collins can go from a 19-point scorer to a 23-point scorer next season, like Brandon Ingram, he's only going to be 22 years old, which is just insane. A 23-point scorer at 23 years old is once again telling signs of what he could be for the remaining of his career. At number 3, I have Bam Adebayo. As a Heat fan, I am super excited to watch Bam go to work next season. Just like Mitchell Robinson, he's a guy that is a young player that has the chance to now be the starting center on his team. Obviously, last season for the Knicks, it was DeAndre Jordan, and for the Miami Heat, it was Hassan Whiteside. I believe the defense for the Miami Heat will look very, very good next season, as we've got Jimmy Butler and Justice Winslow and Bam Adebayo to lock down the front court. Bam is only 21 years old. His stats don't really reflect how good he was, but 9 points and 7 rebounds in only 23 minutes per game definitely has some telling signs of what he could be in the league. Now that he's the starting center, he will probably average around 30 minutes per game. 14 points, 11 rebounds, and I believe he can actually improve on his blocks to maybe 1.5 to 2 blocks per game. I believe that Bam has improved on his offensive game a lot. He already came into this league with tenacious hustle, great rebounding, and crazy athleticism. And we saw a guy like Montrezl Harrell last year who really elevated his game and showed what he could do. I believe that Bam Adebayo could take that next step and be like a Montrezl Harrell type of guy next season for the Miami Heat. At number 2, I have Jaren Jackson Jr. Just like Mitchell Robinson, I don't really like to put guys that have just come off their rookie year into this, but I believe that Jaren Jackson is an exception. Simply because last season, he was only 19 years old, only played 58 games, only played 26 minutes, and still managed to average 14 points and around 5 rebounds per game. Next season, I believe he could have a John Collins leap. Like I said, John Collins elevated his scoring from 10 points to 19 points. He got to play alongside Trae Young. I believe that Jaren Jackson playing alongside Ja Morant could elevate him to be more of a scorer. And if Jaren Jackson averaged 14 points last season, if he elevated his game just to average 7 points, he could be a 20-point scorer in his second season. Not to mention, he will play more minutes next season, have more experience, put on more size, and I believe that that could be huge for Jaren Jackson next season. So he's the guy that I have as the exception, because I legitimately believe he could be a 20-point scorer at just 20 years old in his second season in the league. And at number 1, I have Jaylen Brown. Jaylen Brown ahead of Jason Tatum. And I know that a lot of people are like, oh, I don't know about that. Jaylen Brown entered this league as the 3rd overall pick. He was a very good player coming out of college, but once he got into the NBA, he just hasn't had the opportunity. He's had to play alongside Kyrie Irving, and then they got Jason Tatum. They put Gordon Hayward in front of him in the starting lineup. He really hasn't had his chance, and in his first season in the league, he only played 17 minutes and averaged 6 points. And last season, he only averaged 13 points, but he only played 25.9 minutes per game. I believe now he's the guy that can elevate this team to the next level. And I wouldn't put it past him to average around 18 points next season for the Boston Celtics. If they can just have Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown together, it could be a very, very nice duo. I believe it can be like a Ray Allen, Paul Pierce type of combination. Not in the sense that Ray Allen is a shooter and Paul Pierce was a small forward that can basically do it all, but more so the fact that Paul Pierce only ever averaged around 2 more points than Ray Allen. And I believe it can be the same thing with Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, where Jason Tatum averages around 20 points and Jaylen Brown averages around 18. I think instead of looking at Jason Tatum, we look at another top 3 overall pick in Jaylen Brown and see what he does next season alongside Kemba Walker and the Boston Celtics. With that said, let me know your players that you believe under the age of 24 can take the next step next season. If you want to see players over the age of 24, let me know down below by hitting that like button, subscribing if you're new, hit the notification button, and follow me on Instagram, and I will catch you guys in my next video. I am out.